Romeo, straight out the Shadow Realm, back from another reaction. Today I'm going to be checking out SpongeBob Conspiracy Theory number 7, The Robot Invasion Theory by Alex Bell. Could you tell? I'm about to get into this reaction. Let's go.
A little
crazy. Bro, how wild could this get?
I mean, Goofy Goober, Alien Death Cult Theory, Pearl's Dead Mother Theory.
I remember
Let's
that
maybe
one.
Maybe try and slow down a bit on this one.
I agree.
There is a secret robot invasion happening in Bikini Bottom.
Bro, it got louder than my conscience. Let's turn that down.
Where you looked, robots have integrated themselves into society, kidnapping and replacing people with robot cyborgs. Waiting
what?
For their chance to rise.
That's what's happening?
The robot apocalypse.
Not on SpongeBob, is it?
I repeat, the robots are coming. The robots are coming.
Yeah, he's scaring me for a second. Damn.
Robot invasion theory.
Let's get it, baby. Robot invasion theory. What's going on? He always got it. What's this? What's this, guys? He's just shooting some b-ball outside the school when a couple of guys, they were up to no good. Right, you get it. You get what I'm saying. He good?
Alex.
Oh. Sorry, what?
You okay, dude?
Sorry. I've just got a lot on my mind lately.
How's the SpongeBob theorizing going?
It's good. It's good. I'm actually thinking about maybe stopping.
Why?
They're Why? Huge. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, people watch them. I didn't go to film school for 3 years just to make SpongeBob theories forever.
Why
yeah,
not?
But I mean, it's just something you're doing now. Doesn't mean you have to do them, like, forever.
She got
it's
a point.
For you to say. I mean, what, you're a year out of film school and you're already directing commercials?
Yeah, but I didn't go to film school to make commercials either. It's just something I'm doing for now. Like SpongeBob theories.
Mm-hmm. Yep. You got a good point.
I don't know. These videos also just... They take a lot to make. I'm not sure if I'm up for it anymore.
Damn, he giving up? Bro.
He's like watching cartoons all day. That sounds awesome.
He's one of those. Bro, he's one of those. Bro, they're not even swinging. What's creaking?
Hey, it's time for another SpongeBob conspiracy. Wow,
Let's
I just realized I've been making SpongeBob videos for over a year now. Definitely did not think that I'd still be making these a year later. But it's all worth it, right? Because you guys love them. And
exactly.
Them,
I like
they're,
them.
They're super easy to make. The sponsor.
Are they?
Time to talk about today's sponsor. Do you like intense?
No, I don't. No, I don't like that.
Games, epic rosters with hundreds Mm-mm. of characters to play in Boston.
No.
Well, then you'll love Wine from Bright Cellars. You know, after a long day of SpongeBob,
whoa,
theorizing,
he tricked me.
I'd like to crack open a nice cold wine.
Yo, he bamboozled me.
Red. But here's the thing.
Alex
Bay, really
a wild boy for
wine.
This one, man.
That's why it's good. Bright
he
Cellars
a wild boy for this one.
Back. Bright Cellars is a monthly wine subscription service that helps people discover wines that they'll love. First, you just take a quick personality quiz, then they send you a box of wines specifically based on your taste. Each wine comes with educational cards that tell
that
you how to best serve it.
That do sound delicious, don't it?
Trust me, they know
wine?
You better than you know yourself.
Do they?
This is the Forever Fleeting. Very good, very good. I'm getting a little bit of peaches, which is nice.
I forgot my mother removed my pillow.
Peach cobbler my mom used to make me as a kid.
Where'd my mother end up putting a pillow at?
They always know. They always know. A little bit of apricots, too. Kind of like the first kiss I ever had at the Sadie Hawkins dance.
Yeah, the Sadie Hawkins dance. He a wild one for the Sadie Hawkins dance. Bro, let's get to the theory, bro. What the hell?
One of my favorite episodes of SpongeBob is the season 3 episode Crabborg. SpongeBob watches a scary robot movie.
Oh, I remember this one.
Worried about robots taking over and even kidnaps Mr. Krabs.
I remember this one, bro.
You think I'm a robot?
Yeah.
We know.
It's a really funny episode, but I can't help but wonder if SpongeBob's fears might be a bit more justified than we thought.
What we talking?
In the episode SB129, we get our first
glimpse
of the
I remember this episode too.
Later.
Okay, what's going on here? Why is everything chrome?
Everything is chrome in the future.
We see a world covered in chrome.
Oh, what the hell?
Everyone has been replaced with robotic people.
SpongeBob, is that you?
SpongeBob? No, I am SpongeBob.
SpongeTron.
We see a future full of robots. In the season 7 episode Back to the Past, SpongeBob time travels to an alternate future where Man Ray takes over, and once again, people are replaced by robots. And then, in the second SpongeBob movie, Water, there's a deleted scene where SpongeBob and Plankton go to the future and see this.
What they see?
We did it!
I wonder when we are. Excuse me, sir. Do you know what year this is?
Cyborgs? They always cyborgs.
We went front in time. In episodes that take place in the present. In the Krusty Krab training video, we hear this.
Well, luckily for you, Mr. Krab's fear of robot overlords keeps the balance of technology in check.
And in Insecurity Guards,
he's got a robot overlords.
Clearly shows the evolution of SpongeBob eventually getting taken over by robots. Okay, so there seems to be a lot of evidence for the future of Bikini Bottom being taken over by robots. But
right.
Honestly, why does any of this matter? I mean, robots ruling the world is a pretty common depiction of the future in lots of different media.
Mm-hmm.
And even if this is the canonical future of the show, it's at the very least thousands of years in the future. It's not like we can already see this robot invasion happening in present-day Bikini Bottom, right?
We can't.
Here's an question about SpongeBob that's always bothered me. Why are there so many robots in the show? And I'm not talking about Sandy or Plankton's inventions. It makes sense for them to have robots since they're both geniuses.
Yeah, geniuses, right.
But why do hospitals and office buildings and amusement parks and Weenie Hut Juniors and many, many...
Whoa, bro. That's crazy. I never even noticed there was that many robots, bro.
Advanced robots.
I didn't even realize there was that many robots.
Super advanced society, right? Tobots. You wouldn't really say that they have much futuristic technology, except when it comes to robots. But why? And what's even stranger is that there are many, many instances where these robots suddenly turn evil.
Damn.
The first time I really started to notice this was in the season 7 episode
Tunnel of Love. I see this
episode. SpongeBob and Pearl get trapped in a glove world.
Season 7, I see this
full
one.
Of animatronics.
Nah, I see
Patrick
this one.
Tries to set them free by breaking into the control room, but accidentally causes all the animatronics to suddenly turn evil and attack SpongeBob. This is a pretty basic cartoon trope. Someone accidentally breaks the controls, then the robot malfunctions and turns evil. This isn't really all that weird for SpongeBob. Except, what's strange about this is that Patrick doesn't break any controls. He hits a button labeled animatronic override, and that's what causes the robots to turn evil.
I'll just gingerly lean on this wall. Huh?
That wasn't gingerly, that was actually really aggressive, as you can see.
They aren't malfunctioning. The robots were intentionally designed to have a button that makes them attack people, but why? Then, in the episode Good Neighbors, Scooper discovers a flyer for a home security system that's suspiciously free, despite it clearly being very advanced. After he sets it up, his house suddenly grows arms and legs and starts destroying Bikini Bottom.
What the fuck?
Whoa, Squidward's house is
that happened in an episode?
Now, to be fair, this was a malfunction caused by SpongeBob, but why would a simple home security system have giant arms and legs? I mean, the malfunction didn't create them, they were clearly already installed. They eventually do manage to stop the house, but what's really creepy about this is that we can still see signs of Squidward's house being sentient after this episode. Then, in the season 11 episode Krusty Cleaners, SpongeBob and Patrick go to an office building and encounter a trash cleaning robot. The robot immediately attacks them for causing a mess.
Immediately attacks them.
Bro.
But this time, there's no malfunction that causes this. It's working exactly as intended. Not only does the trash robot have a buzzsaw and a literal laser cannon, but it also turns all of the nearby machines into killer robots to help hunt down SpongeBob and Patrick. So, where are all these places getting these super advanced robots, and
that's what I'm saying.
Why are they all being programmed to suddenly turn evil?
Right.
A question that stumped me for a while. Until I watched the season 11 episode, My Leg. This is the episode where I truly realized there was an actual conspiracy theory here, and not just cartoon.
Alright, what's
animals.
The...
It's time we finally find out who
what's,
is behind...
What's behind it? Probably Plankton or somebody, right? How to get a wild animal out of your house. That's an interesting way to segue into the next segment. But, it says tentacle monster out of your house, and that ain't gonna work. You ain't gonna find that on Google. I tried, I looked. looked. Ooh, I looked for that question.
Hey,
we ain't gonna find that one.
I'm still serious about you leaving this house. It's not that I don't appreciate everything you've done for me.
You don't wanna go though, bro.
I think you want very different things. You know, I don't want it to come to this, but I will use force if I have to, so you better go.
The mastermind.
The episode My Leg focuses on the reoccurring gag of this one fish always injuring his leg throughout the show.
I remember those. He should have got an episode sooner, to be honest.
At one point in the episode, he goes to a hospital and meets a robot that works there. It's just a small throwaway gag. The robot never turns evil or does anything strange.
Don't take my leg! Don't take my leg!
But there's something awfully familiar about the robot's design. Let's go all the way back to the season 3 episode Plankton's Army, which opens with Plankton trying to steal the Krabby Patty's secret formula with a robot disguise.
You never know what trick he'll use to steal me secret Krabby Patty formula.
What a quaint restaurant. I think I will sample their wares.
These robots have an uncanny similarity.
They do look very
right
similar.
The same tie. Okay, but maybe we could just chalk
shape
up
is the same too.
Being lazy and reusing assets. But SpongeBob has always had a pretty diverse amount of robot designs throughout the show.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not like this is a direct copy-paste either. They went to the effort to redesign the face and colors, but it was still clearly based on Plankton's robot. So
it's Plankton. It's Plankton.
Plankton has built
it's
many
Plankton.
Robots to try and steal the Krabby Patty secret formula. But I think after he fails to do so, he doesn't just throw them away. He redesigns the robots and then gives them to different businesses in Bikini Bottom.
That's nice and noble.
To one day use them to take over the world once he has enough in place. I mean, we know what Plankton really wants isn't the secret formula, it's to rule the world.
I will rule the world!
And there's even the video game, Battle for Bikini
Where
Bottom,
he wants to rule the world.
Plankton tried to take over using an army of robots. So, this theory doesn't seem too far-fetched for Plankton's character.
Nah, don't.
We're gonna need a lot more evidence if we're gonna prove he's the one behind all the robots in Bikini Bottom. So, let's get started. In the season 3 episode, No Weenies Allowed, we see a robot working at a place called Weenie Hut Juniors.
Would you care for another Diet Cola with a lemon twist, Weenie?
And while it doesn't resemble any of the robots we've seen Plankton make, does that voice sound familiar to you?
Would you care for another Diet Cola with a lemon twist?
That shit's like a Weenie.
Restaurant. I think I will sample their wares.
And again,
it's right there,
like
yeah.
The default robot voice we hear in SpongeBob. There are many different voices the show has used for robot characters.
What a quaint restaurant.
Greetings, I am Robo 2.1.
No threat detected.
This is very uncomfortable.
Yeah, they all sound different.
But here, they specifically recreated the voice from Plankton's robot. Let's go back to Glove World for a second. In the control room, we see a machine on the wall that looks shockingly like SpongeBob. So much so that Patrick even mistakes him for it. We know Plankton has built a SpongeBob robot before in Welcome to the Chum Bucket. Maybe he repurposed it here inside of Glove World. In Krusty Cleaners, the trash robot also has a striking resemblance to Plankton's robot in the Season 9 episode Eek and Urchin. In the Season 5 episode The Patty Gadget, Squidward tries to get SpongeBob fired by replacing him with a machine that creates Krabby Patties for free. But it's never explained where Squidward got
what
this machine.
The fuck?
Now, it doesn't resemble anything we've seen Plankton make, but a staple in a lot of Plankton's inventions is having them resemble his likeness, especially with one eye in the middle, and that's exactly what we see with the Patty Gadget. And the patties it makes are terrible, which would make sense for something Plankton made. In the episode All That Glitters, SpongeBob buys a super advanced talking spatula.
Spatula
3000
at your service.
Spatula 3000. But in the episode Evil Spatula, we find out Plankton has a whole collection of advanced spatulas just like this one, and even tries to trick SpongeBob into taking a talking spatula. It seems like no matter where we turn, we can find a connection between the technology in Bikini Bottom and Plankton. But, if you remember in those glimpses of the future, the world isn't just ruled by robots. They've actually replaced all the existing citizens with robot copies.
I am SpongeTron.
And believe it or not, this is also something we can already see happening in Bikini Bottom today. Get ready to see how far this robot invasion has really gone.
Damn. How far does it go? I just went on a damn rail.
Hey, Victoria, what are you doing here?
I was just around, thought I'd stop by. Can I come in? Or?
Inside? No. It's just
you got a monster in there, bro. Leave.
In all honesty, it kind of seems like you're going through something.
a psychotic break, maybe? This dude is going crazy. He's bonkers.
The SpongeBob stuff has been keeping me really busy. I'm a little stressed about that. But I'm fine. You should probably go.
Bro, he's off his rocker.
Not answering your phone. You're living in total darkness. You just talk to me. What's going on?
Okay, fine. Okay, we can talk. Just not here.
Fine. Do you want to get coffee or something?
Sure, fine. Yeah. I gotta put something away. Just stay right here.
Trust no one.
Now, we know Plankton has tried to turn people into robots before.
Mm-hmm.
SpongeBob, come in here! Or should I say
Robot Bob?
But he gave up after SpongeBob was too annoying.
You've got to take that yellow nightmare back! It's not worth it!
But I don't think this was his only attempt. In the season 11 episode, The Checkup, SpongeBob and Squidward are trying to give Mr. Krabs a health checkup by testing his pinching reflexes.
I remember this episode.
Plenty of things for Mr. Krabs to pinch. Pinch of salt.
And one of the things they have him pinch is a baby.
A baby's cheek. Lucky that was a robot baby.
Some random baby just turned out to be a robot, and it's never explained why.
That's no, they didn't explain it. SpongeBob. No, I thought that was weird too.
Interesting. When we go back to season 9 in the episode Plankton's Pet, where Plankton tries to steal a Krabby Patty using the exact same purple baby as a robot disguise.
That diabolical fiend! I can't believe this is working.
And we're not even done yet. If we go even further back to the season 5 episode Goo Goo Gas, we can actually see the exact moment where Plankton gets the idea to turn the baby into a robot.
Why, you're so tiny and helpless. I could take your formula whenever I wanted to, and you couldn't do a thing about it.
What the hell?
That's it! Finally, victory will be mine.
Now, in the episode, it's implied that this is just him getting the idea to turn everyone into babies to steal the formula, but isn't it crazy how it also perfectly lines up with the purple baby fish suddenly turning into a robot in future episodes? Now, there's another fish that's always been very suspicious to me. The strangely realistic news anchor fish.
Yo, we gonna go into news anchor fish, who is also a robot? Well, that's kind of obvious, right? Because what kind of fish he is.
In a show full of cartoon characters, why is he the only realistic one? In fact, I made a whole theory about how there are evolved cartoony fish that can talk, and primitive realistic fish who can't. But as many people have pointed out, the one exception to this is the realistic news anchor fish. Well, if you ask me, he looks a lot like one of those animatronic singing fish.
Yeah, he does look like that.
Especially the way he mechanically moves his mouth and how we only ever see one side of him. So, already a pretty strong indication that he might be a robot, but there's also something familiar about his voice.
What kind of cruel, careless, evil person? I'll canvas all the
It sounds like Plankton.
That's right, he has the same voice as Plankton. And if you're gonna take over the world, then you're definitely gonna want to control the media. But how exactly is Plankton replacing these people with robots? Well, I think the season 10 episode Whirly Brains gives us an important clue. In this episode, suddenly a new toy becomes extremely popular in Bikini Bottom, the Whirly Brain.
Just flip your lid, attach the propeller, and watch your brain soar under the beat into the air!
Yeah, it's a weird episode. So, people are actually voluntarily attaching devices to their brains and ripping them out of their bodies, and no one thinks that this is suspicious? If you ask me, this seems like the perfect way to
really
replace
suspicious.
Someone with a robot. Remember, in Welcome to the Chum Bucket, Plankton told us how he turns people into robots.
I'll be forced to remove your brain and implant it in my robot chef!
By removing their brains.
And putting in a robot.
Is there any proof that he's the one behind the Whirly Brain toys? Let's take a look at the new SpongeBob prequel, The Patrick Star Show. Every once in a while, the show cuts to this stop-motion parody of Frankenstein with Plankton, and he actually uses Whirly Brains to conduct his experiments. It's not super clear how this all connects to the main show. I mean, we do see Patrick interact with the stop-motion Plankton at some point, so they're at least in the same universe, but regardless, it's still a solid connection. We see another head-based gadget in the season 11 episode Bottle Burglars, an invisible helmet being advertised in a magazine for only 99 cents. And in the same episode, we see Plankton using the exact same helmet.
Crabs will never see me coming, Inviso.
Now, Now, maybe this is just implying that he bought the helmet from the magazine, but that doesn't really line up with what we know about Plankton as an inventor. Plus, I can't see them selling a tiny version of the helmet just for Plankton. Seems a lot more likely that Plankton created the helmet and is selling them to the people of Bikini Bottom, possibly as a way to create more robots.
Wow. Alright,
so we're starting to get a pretty clear idea of how Plankton plans on turning the citizens of Bikini Bottom
into robots. Right.
But there is one more character that I believe has already been secretly assimilated into a robot.
What character?
And it's not some random background character either. It's one of the main characters in SpongeBob SquarePants.
Who is
this final part of the robot invasion theory is going to completely the entire show. Are you ready? Because this is the Patrick Star theory.
What? And also what? Because we just transitioned to him putting a knife away. Yeah, recipe sad dog, cause he gone. Whoa, did she?
Shit. Victoria? Victoria?
Oh shit.
Now, I fully realize saying Patrick is a robot is a very bold claim. But hold your judgments till the end. By far, the most requested theory I get on this channel is to cover Patrick Star, and more specifically, his inconsistent intelligence. Throughout the entire show, there are these little moments where Patrick suddenly says something smart.
I'm a bit more complicated than that. The inner machinations of my mind are an enigma.
And then immediately goes back to being.
Oh, what the hell?
There's so many examples of this happening that many people have actually made.
Patrick is secretly a genius.
Is Patrick secretly a genius and just pretending to be dumb? Does he have a secret split personality?
I diagnosed Patrick Star with trauma-induced anxiety triggered spontaneously duplicate multi-intellectual
what?
Of a mental multiverse.
I've come to a bit of a
different conclusion.
Have you ever noticed how every time we see Patrick try to think, there's either sparks or smoke coming out of his head? And almost every time we see inside of Patrick's head, it's represented with gears or some kind of machinery.
Yeah, that is true.
Now, we're supposed to assume that this is just a cartoony way to visualize thoughts, but what's strange is just how consistent they are with it. And even stranger, none of the other characters' thoughts are visualized this way.
Just got an order from the
boss. They're visualized differently.
It isn't about fine dining. Squidward's happy gland is forced to take shelter in the recesses of his mind.
It's only Patrick who seems to have this robotic association with him. And just look at how detailed they are with it. While Patrick's head is sparking in Rule of Dumb, if you look closely, you can see a spring pop out of him, and even a hole left behind by the spring. That is such a small detail that no one would notice unless you were going frame by frame. And if this is just supposed to be a metaphor inside of Patrick's head, how come SpongeBob clearly
sees
the spring come out? Okay, so let's entertain the idea for a moment that Patrick might be some sort of robot. How would he have gotten converted, and why does this cause him to randomly become smart every once in a while? Well, I looked at all the scenes where Patrick suddenly does something smart, and I noticed a bit of a pattern. There are two different types of these moments. There are times when we think he's saying something intelligent.
Wait, SpongeBob! We're not cavemen! We have technology!
But then it's revealed he's not This doesn't contradict his character at all. Patrick is someone who doesn't see himself as dumb, so there's lots of times when he tries to be smart, but he fails.
Dumb people are always blissfully unaware of how dumb they really are.
It's a good point.
But there are also moments where he actually does do something undeniably smart.
Wait a minute, Squidward. They might be onto something.
We could filter the CO2 through our ballast tanks, refire the engines, and ride the shockwave out of here.
Wow. He's right.
But then he immediately acts oblivious to the fact that he was being smart.
We're going through with your plan, Patrick.
Yay!
What plan?
So, I kept track of these two different types of moments, and it seems like after season 3 is when he suddenly switches from pretending to be smart to actually having these smart moments. And this switch perfectly lines up with the season 4 episode, Patrick's Smarty Pants. In this episode, Patrick falls off a cliff and gets his head knocked off. SpongeBob accidentally replaces his head with some brain coral, which makes him become a genius.
I find all this laughter to be highly illogical.
In the end, they switch back to his normal head, and Patrick goes back to his usual stupid self. But take a closer look at the scene when he first puts on the brain coral.
Here's your head.
Everything starts, now, the cog starts spinning, and they weren't,
a metaphor for Patrick's brain never being used until now. But these gears are not from Patrick's brain. His brain came off during the fall, which means these gears are entirely from the brain.
The brain coral.
And at the end of the episode, when they remove the brain coral, we can still see the electrical plug attached to it. We are no longer seeing a metaphorical representation inside of someone's head.
Yeah, that's like full on, that's what it is. Yeah, yeah.
The brain coral is just like the Whirly Brains, a robotic device that plugs into your brain to control you. Isn't it convenient that Patrick just happened to land next to a pile of coral that looked identical to his head? Is it possible that Plankton saw this as an opportunity to add another victim to his robot invasion?
It's possible.
After Patrick removed it, he went back to normal, right? He completely stopped Plankton's plan, right? Well, one season later, in the episode Sing a Song of Patrick, Patrick attempts to use his brain again, and we see the same gears inside of his head.
Come on, you stupid brain!
Yeah, those are the gears.
The creators went out of their way to recreate the exact placement of all the gears from the brain coral, which means the head Patrick put on at the end of Patrick's Smarty Pants was not his head. It was another piece of robotic brain coral. But it seems like, for whatever reason, this brain coral isn't as effective as the first one, and he's only able to have rare moments of genius. In the season 12 episode, SpongeBob's Big Birthday Blowout, Patrick has another one of his smart moments.
Oh, would you look at the hour! It's almost time for me to take SpongeBob on that tour so you guys can decorate his house!
What?
But this moment in particular is very interesting because Plankton is actually there to witness it. And take a guess how Plankton responds to him.
Yeah, I guess even a broken moron can be right once a day.
He calls Patrick a broken moron because he knows Patrick is a broken one of his experiments. And if you still don't believe me, in the newest episode of season 13, The Goofy Scoopers, we get this scene.
This stinks. I wanted to go backstage for an autograph.
Plankton was here. Yes, he certainly was. And that is the robot invasion theory.
That was wild, bro. I just blew my mind all the way to the possibilities
robot
of
invasion theory done. Hey, we just passed 500,000 subscribers. Thank you guys so much. This is honestly a dream come true for me. I mean, I've always wanted to have this many people watching me for SpongeBob theories. You guys wouldn't like all immediately unsubscribe and leave me if I stopped making these, right?
No.
Thanks again for watching. I've been your host, the SpongeBob guy. I will see you.
There's a wild theory.
See you guys. Bye.
Oh, let's get that after credit scene, baby. Let's get a conclusion to the real story.
Do not give me the silent treatment right now. I swear to God, if you did something, I'll...
Oh, he definitely did something. Yeah, he definitely did something, bro.
Oh my God!
Victoria! Where were you?
I was using your bathroom. Why the fuck?
I figured that's what happened.
Okay, it doesn't matter. Okay, you cannot be here right now.
No, I am not leaving until you tell me what's going on.
Listen, I promise I will explain everything to you later. You cannot be in here.
Why are you so afraid of me being in your house?
Victoria, I promise you, this is not the time. We have to leave right now.
Your muse isn't gonna eat me.
Muse isn't gonna eat me.
You mean the tentacle monster in my basement?
Yeah.
How do you know about that?
I have one too.
What the fuck?
What?
What the fuck? What the fuck?